All right, this is not going to take much time. So afternoon I showed you this demo of Nereid. So I just want to show extra bonus feature that you get when you switch to Nereid, and if you're running something like an e-commerce system. All the images that you see here are generated real time, resized and modified by Nereid. So how does that work? Let me show you. Okay, so if you see the URL here, it says this is Harvest Moon. So if you want this at a smaller size, you can just change the URL. This points to a Nereid server. So Nereid resizes the image real time and sends it back. So if you're building an e-commerce store, you don't have to build multiple, you don't need a designer to build multiple sizes images and store them. You can get these images on the fly. But there is a catch. Image manipulation is extremely slow in Python, or for that reason in any language. So you need something like a front-end cache. So if you have HTTP/Proxy or Varnish, in this case what we are using is Amazon's CDN. So from the CDN, it pings back to Nereid if it doesn't know the URL. If it knows the URL, it comes back. You can do a whole bunch of stuff like resize, rotate the image, and you can even write on the image. Maybe you want to have a watermark, so you can do all that kind of stuff just on the URL itself. So in your template, you change how it looks. So you redesign your template, your image sizes change.
Is it the Python version of image magic or something else?
It's built Python imaging magic.
I tested their Flash extension about create tombs in local. I tried to integrate to Nereid. But tomorrow I tried this model. But I got a Flash extension to generate the tombs. And the first resource is very good. And crop and resize. You can decide.
Yeah, you can grow, you can resize, yeah. You can rotate, you can.
No,
okay,
I think not, but draw, I cross.
Why putting the parameters in the name of the resource instead of passing as parameter?
Ah, that's because front-end caches behave differently. Some front-end caches will not respect URL parameters. They only check for the URL URL path. They don't look at the parameters. So even if the parameters change, they think it's the same thing and they keep returning the old object. So,
exactly. The name of the file is different than the browser, for example, says, oh, I don't want this name.
Yeah.
But the parameter should be part of the cache.
Should be, but it depends on browser.
And Nereid answers the query by saying to the browser to fetch the image on the Amazon CDN. It's a redirection or it's a
no. It is when this URL, what we have here, it's the same as you can directly write. If you do this, this image is going to be generated every time.
Okay.
But when you have the front end cache, that caches the image for some time. So if you reload here, if you reload, it's going to transfer the same image again. But there, it's from the CDN, so it's regionally cached wherever from the nearest POP.
After you store the images, the original images, are they stored in the
file? They're stored in the file system. In this case, I think it's stored in Amazon S3.
But how is it? Is it a reference to the picture in the product, or how do you handle
there is a images section in the product where you can choose the large image. So you choose just one large image and the other images can be constructed on the fly.
So you don't upload the picture like a customer or the administrator?
Yeah.
You upload it, right?
Yes.
And then
but they are attachments. They're simple attachments?
No, they are it's a function field. It's
stored
in the file system. Okay, any questions? Thank you.